welcome to the Space Center. It's Gene Kerman, flight director and our guide for this quick introduction. It's the Space Center. From here, you can manage all aspects of the space program. Feel free to have a look around, hold the right mouse button to move the camera, or use the arrow keys. Right-click over the Space Center. That's not the Space Center. That's not the Space Center. Is this the Space Center? I don't know. Is the whole thing the Space Center? Yeah, it is. Okay. I'm sorry. Right-click over the Space Center facilities to learn more about them. And left-click when you're ready to head inside. If you need more info, check on the training in the main menu. I think the only thing I practiced in this game was flying. Yeah, that's got to be great playing this with an exploding CPU. So there's our R&D. There's the astronaut complex, where the astronauts have their complexes. Just kidding. Here's the vehicle assembly building. Here's a tracking station. A space plane hangar. Okay. So, where do I go, guys? Not a trick question. Administration building. Here's where all our strategic decisions are made. So, you have to research science to progress with a fixed budget. Yeah. So, I go to the assembly building, just randomly make a rocket, shoot it off, and get no credit for it. Can take contracts. So I assume I go to the administration building to decide my contracts, right? Am I right? Okay, here's the administration building. Here's all the stuff. Wait, what? Okay, so our head of finances, head of science, head of PR, head of operations. Cool. Strategy. Not the admin building. Okay. I'm 0 for 1, guys. We're leaving the facility. Let's go to the space plane hangar. Let's go to the... I don't know. Go somewhere. Let's go to the tracking station. Let's see. Oh. There are buttons for everything, too. This is the official flag of the space program. Or you could change it. There's the launch pad. Mission control. Okay, let's check out R&D. There's the R&D building. Oh, apparently this is where, if you got your science points, you apply them to stuff. I've got 0 science points. Okay. There's technology. There's a science archives. Make a selection. Aren't any records on the sun. We know absolutely nothing about the sun. Alright, so let's go to the tracking station. Hey, there's Kerbal. Or Kerbin, or whatever. The Kerr thing. It's the tracking station facility, and here you can view all the solar system. Ooh. So they actually could, you know, I guess it is the solar system because that's the sun. There's, like, they've got some funny words for lunar orbit. You've got missions in progress. You see them in the left panel, and you'll be able to take command of them from the screen. Sometimes contracts may require specific destinations in orbit or on the surface, which will also be visible from the tracking station. Lastly, if you want to see the same map view during flight, hit the M key. Okay, cool. Alright, so I suppose... Whoa. Okay, that slowed down just a bit there. Yeah, it was like forever ago, though. And with a computer that could barely take it. With a much older version of KSP, so... I don't think I got very far with it. I think I did stream it, though. I could have forgotten. Maybe I just set up for it and then just never got around to it. All right, so let's go to mission control. All right. Ooh, we can gather scientific data from Kerbin. That sounds really challenging. Okay. Offer expires in 3 days, 5 hours, 55 minutes, and 53 seconds. In the aftermath of disproving arguable theories on how we allegedly did not know what we were doing, a group of clerks from Kerbin World First's Record Keeping Society decided enough was enough, made a nice point about how we somehow were out of ideas. This is where you come in. Give us a quick crew report before launching. It's fine if any of the lights on the control panel are flashing. Control panel. Okay. You mean I can't just, like, strap a guy to a firework and say, "Hey, look, it's a mission." Oh my goodness, I hope Zug's okay. I mean, I understand in some way, at least part of the reason why you feel but anyhow. Yeah, it's unfortunate they can die. So we have not successfully accomplished this mission yet. So your Kerbal's count. Oh. Oh, okay. Good to know. I promise I won't deliberately do anything terrible to Jeb like I did last time. And as I say that, I remember, yes, indeed, I did stream it. And something unfortunate did happen to Jeb last time. And now you'll never know exactly what happened unless somehow Twitch has a record of it. Which maybe it does. Okay. All controllers standing by to watch the firework. I mean, the launch. Alright. Let's take the other simple mission. Launch a vessel. Seemed proper for a group of clerks at Kerbin World First Record Keeping Society that none of us knew for sure if we positively couldn't come up with our next move. It's true, though, that the way we could frequently be disproving dubious theories on how we truly had no clue what to do next was how we raised an inevitably interesting question regarding how we were really stumped by whether we had a big plan after all. This allegedly ended up raising more questions than answers, and now we need your help. Wow, that was a really, really long paragraph with lots of really complex sentences. We'd like to officially start off the space program with a bang, a very controlled bang, preferably. Launch a vessel off the launch pad or the runway. Ooh, I don't know if we could do this. This one seems really tricky. Yeah, no, I like how they choose their words carefully. It's a work of art. Okay. All right, we're gonna test one thing here because I forgot. Okay, apparently Nightbot's not responding to that. I don't know why not. That's really confusing to me. Ooh, active. Archives. Yeah, I think. All right, so we're gonna go to Vehicle Assembly Building. Build something to get us off the launch pad. Yeah. Hello, I'm Werther von Kerman, Chief Rocketry Engineer. This is the Vehicle Assembly Building. This is where we build spacecraft and later roll them out to the launch pad for flight. Pretty impressive, isn't it? On your left, you'll find components to construct your own spacecraft, select a starting point, then attach others to it to make a ship. We'll then have a look around with the right mouse button or the arrow keys. It's not as if we're rocket set. Oh. Anyway, if you need more in-depth explanation, blah blah blah. add uptime. Boop doop 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 boop doop. Oh, did it get added? I don't know. We're gonna add it here. Alright, and then we're gonna do uptime. Alright, so that's my timer for how long food has been in the oven. When that gets to about, let's see. Yeah, I guess once that gets to about 40, it'll be done. Alright, we got a command pod. That's all we got. Oh, we got a booster. Can I get a list of everything? Maybe I can't. Mystery goo containment unit. Ooh. Alright, so, does anybody know how to build a rocket? I mean, we're gonna need a command pod, right? Alright, we got a command pod. Alright, we need some engines. Sure. This is how you build it, right? Do we need a parachute? Or would that be too much? Modular girder segment. Basic fin. Ooh, a parachute. That might not be a terrible idea. Boop! Okay. See, apparently that's all we do. Strap a booster on. Wait, there's a difference between boosters and engines in this game? Well, we got a booster. So we're gonna use the booster. And I suppose some fins to, like, stability and stuff might not be a bad idea either. Can I do, like, control, was it? Or is it shift? Or is it alt? Or how do you, like, hook up these radially? Does anybody know? Or do I just attach one fin? And that's gonna be my thing for this rocket. Or do I just not bother with fins? Are fins redundant? I think one fin would look awesome. Okay. Aerodynamics are for the weak. Okay. Well, that's good to know. Should I add the mystery goo containment unit? Would that be awesome? It's probably not worth it just yet, but maybe later. I mean, this does gain me science whenever I use it, I guess. Oh, click the duplicate thing. Yeah. Okay, hit the duplicate thing. Duplicate somewhere over here. Cycle symmetry. Cycle symmetry count 3, 6. So yeah, now if I click this, I can have 6 fins. Ooh, I can have 8 fins. It's the octafin. Oh man, how much is that going to cost me? So that's going to cost me like 200 just to put up 8 fins. But how great would it be to be the only person who's ever flown an 8 fin? Yeah, here we go. 8 fins for science. That's what it's for. Here, I should put them all as close to... Oh, wait, can I fit them here? Yeah, let's see if... Do they fit here? Perfect! Okay. There's no way this is gonna fail. Yeah. So that cost me 200 just to make an awesome-looking spacecraft. I think we're ready to launch, guys. Remember to EVA... Right. Okay. So, let's launch, guys. I think we made the perfect craft. Alright. Oh, hey, look, Jeb has gloriously volunteered for the mission. But first... All hatches are obstructed. He can't exit. Well, he can't do an EVA to do science. Oh, I know why it's obstructed. So, you remember how I made that awesome looking craft? Turns out that the fins kind of got in the way. Okay. Well, thankfully. Wait. How did he even get in? I need to know this. How did he. Okay. I've apparently already failed the game. I failed the mission. Yeah. We're gonna go back before the launch. Gonna revert the flight back to vehicle assembly. Apparently, I've got to do something about these fins. That's too bad. Okay. Where'd it go? Fins. One, two, three. Here we go. We're making it the octafin. This time we're gonna put them way down here. There we go. I'm sure that's stable enough. Not really. I mean, did he like weld the fin on just to seal himself in? Is he that much of a rebel that he just didn't want to do an EVA? He's like, nope. I'm gonna put these fins in the way so I don't have to do an EVA. Alright. How do I gain the science, guys? Hit the button for the science somewhere. Gather record. Do I like click things? Climb out. Oh, nice! The parachute's gonna fire when we pop the engine. I mean, that's a bad thing. Alright, so. Wait. Okay, so how do I separate this into two stages? Assuming that that's not the behavior I was going for. Do I just, like, drag and drop this up here and nope? Alright, do I drag and drop this up there? Nope. Boop. Hey, look, I created a stage. There we go. Okay, now we launch. And by launch, I mean EVA. Okay, yeah, thanks. Somehow I magically got it. Be the one time I did something right. Whee! Oh no. He did a face plant all over the launch pad. He feels so ashamed. Can I zoom in? Yeah. Yep. Wait, how do I do a screenshot? Is it F10? No, that's not it. Yeah, I forget. Is it F12 to do? Yeah, there's your screenshot. Jeb's feeling so ashamed. Okay. Poor Jeb. I mean, he's not going to space today, apparently. One more for the road. There we go. Wait. Aerodynamic fins assembly disabled. Enabled. Okay, fine. Whatever. Wait. He is able to get up, right? Like, or is it WASD to move him about? Okay, it's WASD. So, I should be able to click on things and make things happen, no? Like, you should be able to plant a flag and other things. Oh, F2 to toggle UI. Okay. Yeah, in case I want the awesome screenshots. Here. Let's see, let's get him next to the rocket. Go. Get him a little off center there. It's probably, but whatever. This will do for a screenshot. He's looking cool next to the rocket. And so, yeah. The space jumps. Jeb's saying he's probably got enough of this. Oh, right click on Jeb. Alright, EVA report. Was the spacesuit really necessary for the EVA? Oof, I don't know, man. Let's keep the experiment. Review the report. Let's transmit it. Look at all. Oh, cannot transmit report. Alright, so we've got an awesome EVA report. Now, in order for that to count, I think we actually are, you know, well, that's cool. So he turns while he jumps. I didn't know he did that. Like, if I hold D and then I hit spacebar. Wait, what was he doing over there? I hold D, I hit spacebar. He was doing this turn thing. That was kind of crazy. I've never seen him do that. Do I need to add a communication thing for the EVA to actually count? I think it still counts for the mission. I just can't get any science for it. Alright, so... Oh, there's the hatch. I found the hatch. Now I just have to jump my way up. Oh, F to climb. Never mind. Okay, so climbing this might be a bit of an ordeal just due to the fins on there. Yep, I definitely did not make it easy to climb. I might have failed the mission, guys. Again. Those glorious, glorious fins. Alright, let's try from this angle. Wait, no. I mean, okay, F to climb. No. Okay, so this might not... Come on, Jeb, you could do it. You've been training your whole life for this mission. Yeah, no, he's not climbing that. Ah! Use your jets. Oh, yeah, I have to resort to using my jet. All right, we'll do it that way. Zoom out. Press shift. Wait, are you sure it's the shift key? Also, wait, was he moving the fins or moving the rocket when he did that? He moved the whole rocket. That's pretty weird. Oh, toggle jetpack on with R. Okay. Yep, so we're gonna use... Oh, it's not enough. It's not enough for this... Oh, hang on. Okay, what's the button once I get up there? Does anybody know the button to actually enter the vehicle? Or am I just trapped outside? Okay. Does anybody know the button? Wait. Well, I can climb it. All right. Mission accomplished. Jeb's on top of the world. But yeah, did anybody get a sight of what that button was that I'm supposed to press to actually enter? E to enter. Okay, that's awesome. Let's see, so... I can't get a good visual here, but I think it's this way. My bad. Jeb is so full of shame. Okay, hang on. F2 for the visual. Doot! Okay. He had to do that. Okay, we're gonna get this rocket off the ground somehow. In hindsight, it'd probably be easier if I just restarted the mission. But... No, hang on. Wait, can I plant a flag somewhere? Apparently, no, I don't have my flag yet. Oh, B to board. Okay. But we're going to get this, guys. This is going to be more challenging than actually flying the rocket. Okay. R to turn on my jetpack. R for the jetpack again. R to turn on the jetpack. Okay, B to board just didn't quite work in that particular situation. But we're gonna get this. Oh yeah! Whee! It's probably not terrible to have that enabled. Okay, so the next question is, of course, we burned up all our fuel. Doesn't look like we're going to make a water landing, unfortunately. So I'm going to need to figure out how to detach these. Don't deploy it yet. Okay, noted. Safe velocity, okay, okay. I should detach the rocket though, right? Oops, well, I just accidentally deployed the chute. I think I did. This might be a problem. Hang on, 400, you're slowing down. Whew. See? Jeb knew exactly what he was doing this mission. Oh man, poor Jeb. Poor Jeb. He wants to do an EVA right now. No, that'd be a terrible idea, but... But yeah. We did remember to put the chute on the craft this time. So, that was all good. Oh, I now see. The solid fuel booster didn't detach from the rocket. Nor should it have, but... Okay, that was cool. I wonder why it took so long for that to deploy, because I thought I was at like 600 meters up or something when I hit the button to deploy it. And it waited until that was around like 200 to actually slow down. Yeah, so I don't have a decoupler, so the solid fuel booster stayed attached. That confused the heck out of me. But yeah. A+, perfect landing. We could do another EVA, but I think we've succeeded at this mission. Let's see. So yeah, we say that we're done flying. Go to Space Center. And then we have to recover the vehicle. Right? All right. We got the EVA report. Look at all the monies we got. All the science we got. That's awesome. 7.4. Parts. Everything should be still intact, hopefully in decent order. Yep, our crew. Our awesome, awesome crew. have been recovered. So we go back and check out. Oh, here it is. Check out our mission control again. And you see we've got nothing active, and we successfully did, in fact, launch a vessel and gather scientific data from Kerbin. Great success. All right. Which mission should we take on next? I'm stalling for time because I'm going to go check out my food in the oven. So you guys, let me know. Where should I look? Should I take this or should I look at one of the other ones here? Okay, I'll let that cool for a minute so I don't burn my face off. Let's see. It used to be a mod called Ferrum's Aerospace that implemented actual fluid models. Holy moly. That sounds crazy. Take anything from your 4-star, possible 5-star restaurant you grew up. Yeah. Yeah, that's cool. Obviously, Cook Serve Delicious is targeted at a different kind of audience. So we got this, the weird frequency at which we find ourselves unintentionally performing high-demand stress testing. Was making engineers passing guy Goliath National Products feel positively brilliant. That eventually made it clear that it seemed awesome that a day in Kerbin was clearly 6 hours long. So that allegedly ended up raising more questions than answers, and as you've probably figured out by this point, this is where you come in. Go to the designated test site and gather some reports. Wait, what? Expires in 3 days, duration 5 years. Take a crew report in flight below 16,700 meters, near area blah blah blah. So if I ever happen to be flying past there, this might not be a terrible mission to have. But yeah, I don't know where that is, and I don't know if that's worth it. It seemed awful that the company heads from experimental engineering group that we're really stumped by whether a day on Kerbin was truly 6 hours long. It can't be denied, however, that the way we would often be undergoing rapid, unplanned disassembly was quite definitely part of the reason. We now need your help. We need to test our newly acquired capabilities with a focused survey of Kerbin. Trivial. Take a crew report above 17,000 meters in another space. Huh. Easy ones are test this part and break the atmosphere. Yeah, so there's all these focused observational studies in various zones. There's another study. Oh, I see. There's a abbreviated version up here, which is the same thing as it says here. Haul MK-16 parachute into flight above Kerbin. expires in one day. Okay, so objectives are have the parachute, Kerbin, flying, altitude, speed. That's worth a try. Sure, let's give this a whirl. Swivel fuel liquid engine landed at Kerbin. Wait, so what's our other thing we got active? Haul a parachute into flight. This parachute's gotta be between 5 and 11,000 meters. Wait, do I even have to deploy it at that height, or just have to haul it? Apparently I just have to haul it. I bet these guys will give me some cool parts to try out this stuff. Alright, so do I want to try the liquid fuel engine or the solid fuel booster? Altitude, woo, that takes you up pretty high. I guess this is probably where I want to go. Yeah, I'll have to have their parachute and then a designated parachute, because, you know, their parachute doesn't work. Oh, that'd be horrible. Okay, so... yeah, well, I guess we'll test this liquid fuel engine. Alright, and let's assemble a vehicle using the liquid fuel engine, using the super special parachute. So this has got to go. Where's my parachute? There's the MK-16 parachute, but that's not the one I get credit for. Here's the liquid fuel engine. Apparently the solid booster's gotta go. So I can attach the liquid fuel engine. But yeah, where'd the parachute go? I mean, surely they're not talking about the MK-16 parachute, because that's the one I used last time. They aren't, right? Where's my missions? Where's my missions? They might be talking about it. We need to check the details. Active missions. Yeah, okay, they are talking about the MK-16. Okay, well, that's cool. There we go. So I need to fly... ooh, Chaospedia. That's fancy. It's like Wikipedia for Kerbal. Ultimately not going to tell me if I have any active missions. Oh, here we go. Okay, altitude 5 to 11,000, speed 170 to 290. Go to R&D and get a decoupler. Alright, let's do that. Decoupler, decoupler, decoupler. Basic rocketry. Gives me a fuel tank, solid fuel booster, and liquid fuel engine, which I already have. Where I get Science Junior Thing. This doesn't say decoupler. Oh, this is a lab. Here's the decoupler. So if I want to spend 5 science, I can get these 3 parts. The communicatron. Oh, that's the thing. Oh, I can afford both. Because I have the science. Yes. Yes, we got all the science. And so the next things are going to be, yeah, 20 apiece. 20 and 18 and 15. And I do not have that much science. Alright, but yeah, now we got a decoupler. Here it is. Just insert it between the things. Like that. Alright. Sadly, all my fins have gone. Caprice can put the decoupler under my primary liquid fuel engine, and then attach a booster below the liquid engine. I see. I was thinking the shapes were wrong, but yeah, you're right. Which booster should I pick? We've got the solid fuel booster, which costs 400, and we've got the solid fuel booster for 200. Any thoughts? Check the contract. Okay, so my goal is to make it to an altitude. I mean, honestly, all they want me is just to use that liquid fuel engine, but my other contract says I need to get to 5,000 and 11,000 at the speed of 170 to 290. I don't think so. I don't think this is mentioning anything about a speed. Yeah, it just says test it. But, yeah, if I want to get to 5,000 to 11,000, maybe I've got to use an arrangement like you're talking about. I mean, our wonderful pilot here last time fell out of the vehicle and had difficulty getting back in. I don't know if he's the one. I don't know if Jeb, our wonderful pilot, should be making decisions about how to put the aircraft together. I don't think it would hurt to add one of these. So, yeah, I guess we'll add one. We'll add the cheap one. Here we go. Probably add some fins for aerodynamics and stuff, and try to actually be sensible about it this time, and, you know, fine. Wait, can I not add fins on this thing? That's really weird. I mean, I can apparently add them on the decoupler, but if I try to add them above there, this just doesn't work out that well. Hover over the liquid engine. So here's our liquid fuel engine. Oh, and the part selector, of course. That just dawned on me as well. All right, here it is.
taking the briefest of food breaks here, because I'm just really hungry at this point.
Let's see.
Show stats you can be. You could do the math and figure out how far you'd go. Or you could just have the cheap solid fuel booster rocket thing underneath and hope it works. We're going to go with the hope and pray strategy. Making a command decision on that one. Apparently, regarding aerodynamics, I have the basic fin. It's not going to do me very much good, but here it is. Again, this is just, like, ridiculous, because, I mean, I can't put it in the middle section, and adding it below that doesn't make much sense either. So, we're going to add the fins up here. Wait, can I rotate this view? Yes. Okay, let's not add the fin on top of the door this time. There we go, that'll do. Somehow. Oh, let's go up. Did that not attach? Okay, I have to go like here if it's gonna... Fine. Hope and pray. Jeb is totally signed up for this. Place your bets. Place your bets. Alright. Yeah, we're gonna turn on RCS mode just to make flight a little bit more stable. I'm sorry, SAS was what I was looking for. And I think it's spacebar to launch. So, can check your center of mass. Oh! I'm sorry, yeah, you can. You know what else you can do? Go! Okay, that was unwise. But too fun. Much too fun. Okay, our mission objectives are there somewhere. Oh. Yeah, well, what can you do? Where do I go to find my mission objectives? Is that here? That's not it. Okay, 5,000 to 11,000. I didn't make it to 5,000. Okay. We're going to pretend that flight went successfully. Keep that on. Oh, I see what you're saying. That launches the parachute and the booster at the same time. So, yeah, it's actually more of a problem than I thought. Wait, so this is a decoupler here. I have to add another stage? Like this? There we go. So then we've got... Yeah. This'll work. Maybe. Here we go. Oops. I'm starting to think... It's fine. It's fine. Wait, how come I... liquid fuel thing didn't... Did I not fuel this before I took off? Like, I don't know. Should my liquid fuel booster thing work at all? I forgot the SAS. No, but seriously. So let's turn on SAS. Assume I don't forget to do that this time. So we got... our decoupler. Then we get the liquid fuel engine. I'm assuming that not all the engines fire at the same time. Maybe that's an invalid assumption. But yeah, here we got SAS and our solid fuel engine. Then when I'm tired of that. My liquid fuel engine's not firing. I hit spacebar once. Not going fast enough. Also, I forgot to deploy the parachute. So what have I messed up? Oh, okay, so it's a separate stage, so apparently I have to fire it or something. I don't understand why it's... Like, am I missing something? So I hit SAS, we do the launch. We get as far up in the air as this can take us. Then disconnect stage 3. And then my liquid fuel thing should be firing if this is a liquid fuel rocket. Is it not a liquid fuel rocket? Also, I'm not going fast enough. I need fuel. Nobody ever told me I had to fuel it up. Jeez. Can't we just fuel it once we're in the air? Do we need a fuel tank? Is that what you're telling me? Oh, okay, so this is a liquid fuel engine, but it had... Technicalities. Jeez. How come nobody ever told me? Okay, fine. Move that. Liquid fuel tank. Move this back. Now we launch. Okay. Turn on SAS and boom, here we go. All right, now all our fuel is apparently burned out or something. Oh, here we go. Now we're going too fast. We deployed our parachute at the right height. Now we just have to wait for him to fall. Yep. Just have to wait. Oh, yeah, you're right. My title's incorrect. Crew report. Dang it, where is my crew pod? Uh-oh. Alright, let's do a crew report. Where's my pod? That's the parachute. Oh, there's the pod. Where's the crew report button? Here it is. Hmm. So much science. Yeah. Oh, sorry, V-Sim. So now we gotta recover Vessel. Somehow. Do I have to go back to the other screen to do that? Or is there a shortcut to do it from here? That's not it. Right, I think I have to go back. So, let's go back to Space Center. And then go recover our vessel. Yeah, somehow Jeb survived it. That's quite impressive. Gotta say. Alright, so now we gotta pick our next mission. How about this one? This one expires in 5 hours, so if we want it, we've got to take it right now. On the other hand, we have to go way up in the air to do this one. Oh, this also requires going up quite high. Yeah, I'm assuming you want to take this as well. Oh, I can't take it. Why can't I take it? Do I have too many active things? Oh, I failed this. Because I did not land with the part. That's the deal. So that's why I'm stuck with these two. Okay, that's cool. Let's just go back to vehicle assembly. And then figure out how do we adapt our thing to work for this mission. Suppose they want me to apply the heat shield, so let's apply that. Heat shield, 1.25M. I guess that has to do with the dimensions of the heat shield. Alright, let's take this. Wait, do I put the heat shield atop? Like this here? Is that how I'm supposed to apply it? Like this? Or is it supposed to go underneath? Well, now I've completely butchered it. Let's don't save changes and try that again. Oh, do click on the parachute. Okay. Well, okay, I've completely lost my rocket. because I said don't save changes, and it didn't save the changes. So yeah, my whole rocket's gone. That's awesome. I got so confused. Okay, so yeah, I promise I'll remember to put the parachute on, maybe. I'm guessing this probably goes underneath instead of on top. And our parachute, here it is. We gotta click that and change this to 0.75. Okay, so each shield does go under the pod, so I did guess correctly. I had a 50-50 on that one. Yep. Okay, so now we gotta hook up an engine and some fuel. So let's add a fuel tank. And then add the liquid fuel engine. And then add a decoupler. Decoupler somewhere. Decoupler, decoupler, decoupler. Is that it? No, that's not it. That's not it. Nope. Nope. Oh, I'm sorry, that is it. So put that there. And then gotta add an engine. Also wouldn't hurt to have one of these, although it wouldn't help either, so let's save that for later, or at least take a look at it once I've assembled the rest of this, and put a rocket on there, and I cannot have a booster for the contract. Okay. Wow, that's awfully picky. I cannot have a booster. How did it say that? Really? Okay, that's cool. I just want to go review the terms of this contract that I signed in blood. I sign all my contracts in blood to let them know I'm serious. I mean, so the one about the liquid fuel thing doesn't say anything about a booster, I don't think. But maybe the heat shield does? I'm just confused. Where does it say I can't do that? Test landed from Kerbin, landed at Kerbin. Swivel liquid fueled engine, Kerbin landed. I thought the deal was just that I had to land with it intact. Apparently, I can't use a booster. Which makes some sense. We want you to test this thing that landed at Kerbin. You have to activate the... Yeah. Okay. Oh. So I have to launch from Kerbin and land at Kerbin. So that means that my first and my last engine have to be this engine. Probably actually the same physical part. Okay. So now I see. So yeah, to actually fulfill that, I have to... That has to be my only engine. Which means... We're gonna fuel up. This is ridiculous. I want to pass both things at once, so 1, 2, 3. I wonder, can I do radial things with these fuel? Let's try this. Okay, that did nothing. As it should. Hopefully this will get us where we need to go. Maybe I should add a fin or two. Yeah, let's add a fin for stability. Oh, better yet, add 8 fins for stability. Actually, so we got our 3 fins up here. Let's do the whole Pythagorean thing and do like 3 and then 4. And then add like 6 below that. Just to really stabilize this thing. It's important that this be stable. There we go. Looks perfect. Put a decoupler under the pod. Buttons on the lower left will show you the center of mass. See, it's in the center. Center of thrust. Yep. Aerodynamic. Perfect. Let's put a decoupler under the pod. Oh. Wait, so I added the heat shield. Here, can I detach the stuff below the pod? So we got the heat shield, and now we're going to add a decoupler. Stack decoupler. Here we go. Has a center of lift above its initial center of mass because it will be too heavy for the... Right. So that's the point. Well, you don't need to know about that, do you? No, okay. But that's actually useful info. Center of mass is above the center of thrust because the rocket's down here and the body's up here. But if we use SAS, it'll all work out. Maybe. Hopefully. Probably not. All right. Check our objectives. Just pin that up there. Toggle SAS. Wait. Does this thing even launch? Hang on. We're going to try that again. Did I not fuel this? I could have sworn that I fueled them. Nope. Well, okay, so something's not entirely right here. I forgot the stage. Oh, are you serious? I thought this thing down here... Wait. How is that even possible? Wait, no. This is... Like, what's going on here? I don't understand. I've got... The liquid fuel engine is tied to the parachute, and the heat shield is on a separate stage. How does the game even let you do that? Okay. That's more like what we want. That's crazy. I would never imagine that the interface would allow for that. And see, I turned on SAS, it'll all be okay. Nothing to worry about. Just need to go straight up to 22,000 meters. We're not going to make it to 22,000, are we? Here, let's turn off SAS just for the fun. But no, seriously, it might be possible for me to reach 22,000 if I just add more fuel. So we're going to add more fuel so we pass this damn mission. And by more, I mean just like two more of these. Oh, but just ignore the fact that the fins don't line up or something. No, this needs one more fin for good luck. Here we go. One fin. For good luck. There we go. Add a booster. Yeah, but you're saying that for my other mission I can't add the booster. Alright, we ready? Here we go. Hmm. That's a bad sign, isn't it? Oops. I might have deployed the parachute instead of the heat shield. Common mistake. Maybe I should try a more gradual launch. Also, maybe that was a lot of fuel. You might have a point. I might need to add more fins. Or just that one of these fuel things here is too many. But, well, it's not going to let me detach that, so whatever. I'm going to try this again. Jeb will be fine. Oops, I went the wrong way. We're gonna try that again. And by that I mean just the launch. So at the last second, I'm going to make a dive to the right because my parachute has completely failed. Wait, did I not satisfy the criteria for the heat shield test? How did I fail that? Also, let's zoom in. Let's see. Oh, here's an interesting view. Like, the altitude was the only thing I was paying attention to, and I think I got that right. Regardless, I'm curious if this water landing's gonna work. It's good to know. Got it. Add more fins. No, but yeah, I'll try that. Man. Jeb's in space, guys. I unintentionally broke my way through the atmosphere. Perhaps. Man, that's really high up. Oh, okay. Shoot. Well, when you put it that way, yeah, maybe I do have to make some changes. Oh man, he almost made it to 120-500M, which would have been a nice round number. Alright, gonna get a beverage. Promise I'll be back in time to deploy the parachute. Maybe. Okay, we're gonna try this. We're gonna try back in the vehicle assembly, try this again. By this, I mean perhaps a more serious attempt. So I think we got 4 fuel things. How do I zoom in? Apparently I don't. Okay. Detach these extra fins up there. This is probably a more realistic a try. Our center of mass and center of lift are not too far from each other. And yeah, we got the heat shield up there. So, scroll wheel zoom. See, when I do the scroll wheel, this is what I'm getting here. So either I'm fully zoomed in, or I don't know. You want the blue one, the center of lift. This one, really? Oh, okay. So we got the center of thrust and the center... The aerodynamic overlay. Okay. Regardless, obviously the mass is going to be above the thrust. It would be tricky to make the thrust above the mass. That would be really tricky. So we're going to try this. This doesn't have all the lucky fins. But, you know, Jeb's lucky enough. He survived everything we've thrown at him thus far. I'm sure he could take whatever we throw at him next. Okay, so I'll wait until we re-enter to deploy this time. Oh, am I just not going fast enough? What's my speed? Speed has to be 1060 to 1540. Well, I obviously wasn't going fast enough there. I'm gonna try this flight again. Speed is at the top of the nav bar. That's this here, right? Oh, wait. Oh, okay. Well, here's my pitch, yaw, roll, stage, docking, toggle map. Oh, the nav ball. Oh, I see. Well, I didn't watch that very carefully. But yeah, it's looking like I might need more fuel. Or just a better plan. So how about this for a plan? Revert... And this time, just launch at our normal thrust. And then as we start to approach the target height, then really burn the fuel. It shouldn't make any difference. Yeah, I think ultimately what I just need to do... So I see, yeah, our speed is 200, target speed's 1,000. Probably what I need to do is just add way more fuel. So... Yeah, I'm definitely hitting the altitude, but not with the speed we need. So I have to go back to assembly and add some more fuel, and that way we have enough to get to where we're going. Fuel. Fuel. Is this fuel? This is a fuel tank. Maybe that's enough.
Oh, it's good to know we gain speed faster the higher we go. So, oh, and that explains, like, yeah. So we've hit a speed of 900, 1000, 1100, 1200. Okay, we've hit our target speed. So yeah, I've deployed, or I don't know what it means by test heat shield. Does that mean I'm not supposed to detach it? Because I thought somebody asked me to put a decoupler before it or something. Regardless, I've lost the heat shield. Yeah, I seem to have lost my heat shield. I'm curious though, when I constructed this, why is that a disposable part? Is that always disposable? Is there no way to say I want to keep this always on the rocket? I don't get it. Well, apparently I'm supposed to just keep it attached. Yeah, this confuses me. Test heat shield 1.25M. Not sure what 1.25M means. Maybe that's just the size of the heat shield. Well, I lost my speed. Maybe I'll gain the same speed going back down. Huh. I hit spacebar once and my heat shield went with that. Is that the problem? Do I seriously just not have a decoupler? No, this is a decoupler here, right? We got our heat shield, and we got our decoupler, then we don't need a second decoupler, and then we got all our fuel, and we got our decoupler and our engine. So I'm not missing any parts here. I've got a decoupler, and I've got my heat shield. Yeah, that's just really weird. You are not losing your heat shield when you stage. Okay, so it is staying attached. So, the fact that I've got two decouplers is just solely to confuse me. Considering that I was the one who put this rocket together, that makes sense. I mean, I could restage some of these things. I could put, well, this is the decoupler, this is the engine. This is supposed to be a fairing between the decoupler and the heat shield.
fearing. Oh, okay. This is an automatically generated part. I don't need to worry about making it. Yeah, so we do have our heat shield there. So, I guess I hope that on re-entry we need to use it. In the meantime, we are in orbit, guys. It's time warp until we get back down. And we'll see if testing the heat shield ends up being a thing being done here. We've obtained 800, 830, 840, 850, 860, 870, 880. We might hit 1060 by the time we get through that part of the atmosphere. It's going to be close. Maybe it's saying that for that entire altitude range. I don't know. Apparently I failed to test it. I just don't understand this game. Oops, that didn't quite work so well. Looks like we're gonna make it, guys. Drat. Bummer. Well, well, well. Yeah, the parachute failed. It was destroyed by the heat and something, it said. So, it's quite a sad note. With that, unfortunately, I'm exhausted. I'm gonna end up reverting back to assembly, and we can't possibly lose Jeb this way. That's too horrible. But yeah, we'll figure this out sometime. Sometime this game will be solvable. I have to click the shield and click test. Oh. Okay, that explains it. I just thought that, I mean, am I completely crazy in thinking that an astronaut's not going to get out of the vehicle and test the heat shield? But okay, there might be some way to test it from inside. Yeah, that makes more sense. That does make sense. Well, that's our crash course, pun intended. All right, we've got to end it on that note, because, yeah, we just do. We've done so many awesome things today. Can't possibly get any better, can't possibly get any worse. And we'll figure out some more of the stuff next time we do KSP. That makes a lot of sense. Yeah. I never thought you'd actually have to, like, perform a test on a heat shield. I mean, goodness. Whatever. Yeah, we'll make it to the moon one day. One day, it'll happen. Maybe that should be a Monday thing. Pun intended. Alright. Yeah, thanks for watching. It's been a fun experience. We'll get the hang of this sooner or later. And I guess I'll see you next time.